Well, please welcome Josh Hartnett, who's joining us live from London.
Hello, everybody.
Josh, congratulations.
I hate following up. Thank you. Thank you very much. I hate following up Sean and Carla. That was an amazing interview.
Weren't they beautiful?
They're incredible.
Yeah, they're going to be brilliant parents. Yeah, love it. Congratulations on Ida Red. It's a pretty dark crime thriller. What was it about the story that made you want to jump on board?
Well, I've always been interested in crime thrillers. It just is, it's a genre that's always been interesting to me. So when I read the script and I thought I could work with Frank and with Melissa and all these other great actors, I jumped on board. It's rare when you come across something that's so complete like this and tells a story that is sort of outside of the norm, but it has a really good sort of resonance for other stories. It just seemed to work.
Josh, I'm also hearing that Sean and Carla are happy to sell you the film rights to their story. we'll keep you posted, mate. In Ida Red, you're fantastic in it, and Oscar winner Melissa Leo plays your mother in the film. Like, even when you watch the trailer, she's scary in the trailer. were you a fan before you got to work with her?
Very much a fan, yeah. And having her play my mother behind glass, it was nice that there was glass between us. I mean, we shot this during the pandemic. There was nothing. We had to isolate. We had to socially distance. So it worked out well for me. She had no access to me. But it's a great character for her, and I think a really nice relationship between the two of us. If you guys want to explain a little bit about this, if you want me to explain a little bit about this, we're a crime family. Melissa has been put in jail. She's my mother, and I've sort of taken over the day-to-day in the crime family, but she's still very much the boss from prison. And my crazy uncle is played by Frank Grillo, who's amazing in the film. And there's another generation as well.
I'm glad you explained, because there are twists and we don't want to do spoilers. We will get in a lot of trouble. You can do all the spoilers you want. We're fine with that.
None of those spoilers.
You've had such an interesting life in relation to your career. So at the height of your fame, you just make this conscious decision just to walk away from big studio films. Now, some of that, I'm sure, is that you were worried one day you might have to follow Sean and Carla. But apart from that, there must have been a real reason, like a deep reason for that. What was it?
Well, I mean, the biggest thing for me was I really enjoy making films, but the industry itself was overwhelming for a 21-year-old kid. The press was a little bit different back then. It was the paparazzi around every corner. You couldn't really go anywhere without being, sort of harassed. And I decided I didn't need that in my life, and I was able to still make films and live outside of it. I lived in Minnesota for a long time, in New York, and now I live in the UK. And I'm still able to work with great people and make good films, and I don't have to deal with all the stuff. So it's kind of best of both worlds for me.
So you're pretty careful on the roles you choose. You've been in some incredible films, Black Hawk Down, a personal favourite of mine, but what boxes does a script have to tick for you to say, yep, I'm on board?
Well, I'd like it to be original. When I find something that I haven't seen in a while, I get excited. I've been doing these sort of independent films for a long time. I've always been interested in independent films because I think that when you're on set with people and they are the ones making the decisions, all the decisions are being made right there, so you don't have the sort of lag time that you would have on a big studio film, where things get sent away for, to be approved, and then it comes back and you have to kind of do something a little bit less exciting than you thought you were going to. But I also have worked on big studio films recently. I've done a couple of Guy Ritchie films, and I'm going off to do another couple this next year. And things are changing because I think the landscape of film is changing. The way people consume it is different, and people's expectations of a big hit are different. It's sort of, you're able to make more niche projects now, which has always been my interest. And then beyond that, it's just the people you work with. The most important thing is the people you work with.
Josh, you've actually been in the spotlight for a number of decades now, but I have to tell you, you look like you haven't aged a day. I'm just wondering, we had Paul Rudd on the show last night. Are you drinking from the same fountain of youth as him? Like, what's your secret?
I'm nowhere near Paul Rudd's ability to. He's Dorian Gray. There's a portrait of him somewhere. I don't get it. I have three kids. I think I'm aging by the minute. Thank you for saying that. I appreciate that.
I would vote Josh Hartnett for Sexiest Man Alive 2022, just quietly. Votes
go.
In.
There we go.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thanks.
You've got one vote, Josh.
Yes, well, yes. Hopefully Carla and Sean will come through.
Your kids will, yeah. Ida Red is available for digital download now. Josh Hartnett, thank you so much for joining us on the project.
Thank you for having me.